friends, in Angular 18.1.0, a new directive has been introduced. In this video, I'm going to talk about this new directive. What is this directive used for? The let directive allows us to create variables directly in the HTML code. This new let syntax will allow developers to define a variable and reuse its value throughout the template. Instead of explaining this theoretically, let me explain this using a simple example. Consider an article in the medium.com. Here we have the author name below the title. And then we have the author name after the article is completed. If we scroll down, we can see here also. And finally, here also. So if we are going to create a site like this, we may also need to show it in different places. In our case, assume the first name and the last name are coming as separate entities. And if we need to show the full name in different places, we can show it like this. But the problem in this approach is, if we need to change something, for example, instead of the first name, if we are asked to use the salutation, we need to change it in every places. So instead of this, we can create another variable and generate the required format and use that in all places. So that we don't want to change anything in the template when there is a change. In Angular 18, we don't want to create this variable in the TypeScript. Now we are allowed to create a local variable in the template itself. Now if we need to change, we can change it here. Let me show you another example. Let me create a cart array with some products. Now let me show this in a table. Instead of calculating this here, we shall calculate in a separate variable and we can use that. Similarly, if I want to highlight the price greater than 50, we can do it using a separate variable and use it here. Sometimes we may have an object like this and we need to show this in template. Like this. Here we can use the let and make it like this. This way our code will be more cleaner. Sometimes, based on some condition, we may need to show something. For example, like this. We might have used this condition in many places. Here, we can use let to calculate once and use it in many places. We can also rewrite this. Like this. Okay, let me also explain one of the key uses of this let directive. First, let me have an observable. Now, let me use async pipe and loop through these items. Okay, sometime we may also need to use it again in different places. Like this. Now, as we are using multiple async pipes on the same observable in our template, it will create multiple subscriptions to that observable. This can lead to performance issues and potential side effects. Now, this can be easily solved using let. Hope you understood. If you like this video, please hit the like button. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.